Now let's take root 2 and find out whether root 2 is also rational or irrational. Okay, we have root 2 here. Let's assume root 2 is rational. It also simply means root 2 can be written in the form of a over b, where b is not equal to 0, and a and b are in their what? Lowest term. So squaring both sides, we have 2 being equal to a squared over b squared, making it a linear, we have 2 b squared equals a squared. Now we are going through the same procedure. I want to find whether a and b are even or odd. But we can see this clearly here that 2b squared, because of these two, all the expression here makes what 2b squared even, because 2 times any number at all will give you an even answer. So we can say that b squared is what? Even. So if b squared is even, it follows that b2 is what? Even, because the square of any even number is even. And since the entire left hand side is even, means the right hand side is also even. So a squared is even, also goes that a is also what? Even. So all of them are even. So b and a are all even numbers. So if b and a are all even numbers, and this one can be clearly seen to be even, so we only change the side of the a to make sure that that is also even, and we can see that. So we say let a be equal to say 2x, and 2x, everyone knows 2x is even, so we replace a with an expression say 2x and replace it back into our beloved equation here. So we are going to have 2b squared equals 2x squared, which expanding gives us 2b squared equals 4x squared. We try to simplify the coefficients here, we get b squared equals 2x squared. And we can find out that 2x squared is even because of these two. Multiplying 2 by anything gives you even. So it implies that b squared is what? Is even. And if b squared is even, automatically b is also what? Even. And if a is an even number, and we've also proven that b is an even number, there is no way you can get an even number or an even number in its simplest form. So we can conclude that since A and B are not in their lowest terms, root 2 is not rational. So if root 2 is not rational, then it means it is what? Irrational. So this is how we prove such situations. Okay, and I hope with this brief explanations we'll be able to tell whether any given number is rational or not. Thank you very much for having time to watch this video. To meet again, it's a goodbye.